Hi, Shalom. My name is Tzvi Sheinbrum. I am a lawyer, an attorney, and a notary in Israel. Today, I'm not going to speak about a legal question. I'm going to speak about the relationship between the IDF, parents, and children. But let me rephrase. When I say children, they're not children anymore. These people, these guys, the girls are 18 years old, and today 18 years old is not a minor anymore. So now you have your child, your baby, going to the army. Well, when I was in the army, parents couldn't call commanders. Parents could not complain. Parents could barely visit when we didn't come home for 28 days or more, depends what you're doing. So, of course, there is a difference between a soldier who is doing service in logistics, or we call this a jobnik, okay, doing something near the house, comes home every night, and someone who is in the combat field, and he comes home once in a while, every 2 weeks, every week, every 4 weeks, depends what he's doing. It's a big difference. Let's talk to these soldiers that they're starting the service in basic training. The first reaction of a parent when the kid calls and says, listen, I can't do it, it's hard. Oh my God, it's tragedy, it's hard. Yes, it's hard. It's not supposed to be easy. A basic training is supposed to be hard, difficult. Why? Because we are taking the kid, the child, and making him a soldier. Now, parents tell me, not once, but more than once, we don't trust the army. Really? You don't trust the army? No. We don't trust these commanders, or young kids. They don't know anything. They're not doing well. My child is suffering. Really? But wait a second. Every night when you go to bed, do you feel safe? Do you sleep well? Yes. I believe you do. And why? Because these kids, these same kids you're saying you can't trust them, they are doing the job. And what is the job? To keep us safe. So I believe you should trust them, and they have experience. That's your first kid, second kid in the army. For a commander, for a second lieutenant, first lieutenant, it's the soldier number 4500. And here I want to tell you a story. I came to Israel. I didn't know any Hebrew. I was poor. I didn't have any family. I went to basic training after 1.5 years in Israel. It was hard. And I went with old Israelis. I was 21 years old. These kids were 18. At this age makes a difference. But big difference, they knew the country. They knew the mentality. And they knew Hebrew. For me, it was all new. So after 3 weeks in basic training, which was long basic training, it was almost 4 months, I was a combatant in the army. I just couldn't do it. In the middle of the night, I just left the column, went to the officer, he was a second lieutenant, said, listen, take my submachine gun, go to hell, I'm done. I'm going back tomorrow. Well, in these cases, depends who is the commander. The next step, you go to jail. This guy was very calm, said, you know what, let's talk. Come here, took him aside, said, listen, it's a lot of soldiers listening to you that you can't do it, that you're just giving up. Let's talk, but I want a favor from you. I mean, you want a favor from me, you're my commander, whatever you say, I have to do it. So what do you want? I want you to listen to me, sleep over, and answer one question. So what's the question? When you say you can't do it, why do you say you can't do it? And my answer was simple. I can't do it. I'm not capable. My knees are killing me. My head is killing me. Look at my arms. Look at my fingers. Look at my ears. I'm all injured. I just can't do it. He looked at me and said, you know, the problem, as I understand, as you don't have a clue, you don't have an idea what you're capable of doing. What you can do is much, much, much more than you think you can do it. Think over, go back to the column. We're going back now to the base, and tomorrow morning you're going to talk. Don't ask me. I woke up in the morning and said, you know what? Pain, nerve pain, I can do much more. I can do much better. Of course, I finished the basic training. I am a major in the Israeli Army. I had hundreds of soldiers under my commander, and I always remembered the sentence. And I always used to tell the kids, don't listen to your parents. Don't listen to anyone else. Not because your parents are not smart, because they are not here. They don't know the system. They are not doing what you're doing. But listen to one thing, to yourself. If you believe you can do it, you can do much more and much better. And in the end, you'll be a great soldier. And I have the honor to have commander hundreds of soldiers that became good soldiers, excellent officers, not because of me, because of them. They believed in themselves. And this is what makes the IDF a great army. A great army, no less than that. Good luck and trust yourself. Shalom.